Look, man, you got these dudes talking about White Lives Matter. Motherfucking bug torches with the off fragrance running around here in Virginia doing bullshit. You know, I think of it like this, man. You do that shit up here, pull that shit up here, come up to Seattle on May Day. We'll see how far you can get. Try that shit in Tacoma. You ain't gonna go a block. You know what I mean? I don't give a fuck what you say. I don't give a damn how you feel. One thing I do know. You racist motherfuckers. Black, white, Asian, Hispanic. I don't give a fuck. Even though, you know, the white folks, they stand out the most because of the bullshit they've been doing for the last few hundred years or so. But just overall, any of you motherfuckers that want to be out here acting racist towards one another over some bullshit, you holding us back as a nation. Look, I'm saying this as a mixed breed child, you know. My grandma, she's full Japanese. My mama's a half, I'm a quarter, you know, so I got both cultures. And I understand, man, I understand that we're supposed to interconnect with one another, share each other's culture, share each other's foods, share each other's mindsets. How were you raised? How were you living growing up, huh? And then you gotta take that and be able to understand the next person. Like, damn, I know you're not like me, and I'm okay with that. We come from different places, you know? But for you motherfuckers out here wanting to hold us back because of skin color, because of where we're from, because of what we believe in, all that shit, man, you better be ashamed of yourselves. What the fuck you want to do, man? What you need to understand is that we ain't going nowhere. This is the United States of America, motherfucker. This is a melting pot. Y'all want so much separation. You want so much fucking separation, yet it's literally fucking impossible to do so. So what the fuck? You better embrace this shit. Embrace these cultures around you. Embrace that shit. Love that shit. You know? I don't understand how motherfuckers want to be mad. What you mad for? Huh? Yeah, I understand that there was a huge, you know, president of the Confederacy, all that shit, and they want to take down his statue. I know you're going to feel some type of way. But you also have to understand what that shit stood for the rest of us. You know what I mean? Yeah. It's not fair. It's not fair. They're taking down our statues, man. Fuck that. It's not fair. Well, think about it like this, man. What did the Confederate flag stand for other than, you know, separation between the colonies? Huh? That's exactly what it stood for. Separation. If you can't get past being separated and being united with these people from other pieces of land, the motherfucker, get the fuck out of here then, because it's just gonna keep coming. There's gonna be more black folks coming. There's gonna be more Hispanic people coming. There's gonna be more Asian people coming. You know, there's gonna be more people willing to mix with other cultures and other people and other races and all that shit. And you're over there talking about White Lives Matter. Get the fuck out of my face with that shit. All I know is, man, you come up here talking that wild shit, I'm smacking the fuck out of you. Me and my liberal homies, we gonna smack the shit out of you. And we gonna be like, yo, get that shit somewhere else. Go the fuck somewhere else, dog. Move somewhere else. We ain't got time for it. And then for our president, not my president, I didn't vote for that motherfucker, I'ma still make my lunch every day. I ain't worried about whatever the fuck he's trying to do. But he ain't even really trying to acknowledge the bullshit that's going down. You know? And it's disappointing. You know me. I'm not a political person. That's the last thing I'm going to be, is political, because there's just so much bullshit in the mix of that where I don't got the patience to even want to understand it, because there's two sides, Democrats, Republicans, then you got independents, and you got the Green Party with the Tea Party. You got all these parties and shit. Whereas we just need motherfuckers to just come together and figure this shit out. But instead, we want to play fucking teams and shit. It doesn't work. This doesn't work. Hasn't worked. Ever. And for people to just, you know, support Trump, I mean, you can if you want to. I read his first 100 days, and, you know, I didn't disagree with it. And it sounded good, but the way that he doesn't acknowledge the hate and shit, and these people and motherfuckers out here getting crazy, thinking that, oh, since Trump's president, then fuck it, I'm gonna act wild, man. Then, I mean, damn, son. I don't know, man. I just know this shit is fucking crazy. It's bullshit going on in this world. You know, like, you got motherfuckers running into protesters, running them over with their cars because he's mad because his shit got vandalized. Hey, look, man, I be mad too. You know what I mean? And at the same time, you don't retaliate with fire. You just can't, because it's just going to make more fire. And then more fire. Then that shit leads to explosions. Now lives is lost. You know? Overall, as human beings, we got to be able to come together in a different fashion versus this protesting and fucking up people's cars and setting fires and shit and beating people up because of Nazis. Like, that punch of Nazi shit. Look, man, that's not going to get us nowhere neither, even though they deserve to get socked in the fucking mouth every now and then. But still, overall, it's not going to do anything for us except create more fires. But, you know, I'm over here in my duplex in Tacoma, Washington, chilling. And these people out here creating havoc and shit. Me, I'm the type of person that just likes to talk. You want to talk about it, you got a problem, let's have a conversation, you know? But if you don't want to have a conversation, you just want to fucking yell and scream and shit, all that, we ain't going to get nowhere, man. We just ain't. So be it, man. So be it. I just had to get that off my chest. If you hear any creaking in the background, I'm sorry. My uncle gave me a rocking chair from like the 70s. It's real comfy. I got to ice my knee, so this is the perfect chair for me to ice my knee, because my office chair is just a plastic bullshit chair from IKEA. I can't get the leverage that I need for my knee to lay on this piece of ice. So be it. But I think I got the microphone set up to where you can't hear that background shit other than my voice. My voice, you know? But, anyways, man, I don't understand, man. I don't understand what the fuck's going on, but I'm just going to talk. I'm going to just talk because it's been a while. I haven't podcasted in a couple of weeks since a night with friends, so it's Sunday. It's August 13th, 2017. It's a Sunday. I said it again. We've been dealing with these fucking heat waves like a motherfucker. It was rough, man. It was rough. See, this is the part where I break it down, you know, pause the audio, and I play some music. I just don't feel like fucking with it right now because I got to use a different audio software, because for some reason my previous software, it don't want to work right now. It doesn't feel like working. So I'm using this other shit. So bear with me. I'll put some music on at the end, though. It's a surprise. But I know you don't care. You just want to listen to some shit. So anyways, I'm going to come back to this subject probably later on. I still want to talk about some other shit. I hiked Rattlesnake Ledge, finally. Rattlesnake, for those of you that may not know what Rattlesnake is a trail here in Western Washington in the Issaquah Alps. It's a very, very, very popular hike. And that was probably the main reason why I didn't ever want to do that hike, is because there's so many motherfucking people there. It's like a garage sale, a good garage sale at REI. That's how crowded that motherfucker can get. And, yeah, you know, it was fun, though. I went with one of my buddies. He was like, yo, man, I'm trying to go hiking, man. You want to go hiking? I was like, yeah, I'm with it. Because originally I was just going to go to MMA class and, excuse me, learn how to beat up a Nazi, you know. But, you know, he said he wanted to go hiking. So I was like, yeah, I'm with it. So we went hiking. We did Rattlesnake because I haven't gone hiking. I've been slacking because I got my car, right? I got a Buick. It's a nice little car or whatever. So I'm just like, man, I want to go hiking, but I don't want to take this thing hiking because I don't see that for what I'm trying to do. But for the most part, like, I hike a lot of the hikes around here. They're off main roads anyways. So honestly, what I did was just give myself a stupid ass excuse why I know damn well I can take my car on these hikes, because the fucking parking lots to these hikes are paved. Whereas there's only one hike that I know in particular, two hikes. There's Pilchuck and Tomi Peak, where you got to drive on dirt gravel roads to get to the trailhead. And, you know, those two hikes out of the fucking 3,000 that I can go on, you know, I just use those as examples. Like, oh, I can't take my car hiking. Yeah, I can, but, you know, I was being a human and giving myself stupid excuses. But anyway, so I never really liked the Rattlesnake Ledge because there's just so many people that are there hiking. So I don't like trying to make my trek up the hills, up the mountain. I don't know. And, like, you have to pass through, like, literally, like, 40 people to get up to the top. You got, like, not even 40, probably 100 or so. I'm not even exaggerating. I think literally we passed by 100 people going down the mountain, going up it. You got motherfucking dogs and shit. Like, there's a lot of foot traffic, so I don't like hikes like that. But anyways, I did it, and it was good. I liked how it was a good hike because it was a steep enough slope where I was sweating and shit. And, you know, me being out of hiking shape, I was sweating like a motherfucker. I was lighter, though. I was about 205 at the time. I weighed myself the other day. I'm at, like, 203, 202. But that's because the weekends, they get the best of me. But anyway, so we did Rattlesnake, got to the top. Motherfuckers came through with some ice cream. There was these kids up there like, hey, man, do you want some ice cream? And I'm like, no, motherfucker. It's like literally, it's like 80, 81 degrees out. I'm black. I'm not putting no milk contents in my body when it's warm out. Because overall, I'm going to poop my pants or something. I'm going to have nasty bubble guts. I have to sit on the toilet and push gas out. I just don't got time for it. I don't have the patience to go through it. You have to set your own boundaries when it comes to milk in the summer. So I was like, nah, man, I don't want no ice cream. Fuckers kept asking us, but we were like, no, we don't want no fucking ice cream. But thank you for asking. And it's funny because you go to a really popular hike anywhere, I feel like. Runyon in California, over here, Rattlesnake, shit like that. And you're gonna see the Twitter or the Instagram women for sure. I saw a few Instagram women on this hike, and I'm like, damn, this is like for real a trend for the Instagram community of these IG models that probably got more followers than I'll ever have, right? I saw this chick out there with booty shorts on, and I'm like, damn, son. Like, I know the reason why you got these shorts on is for the photo. And, I mean, good for you. It got you out the house. But you got your ass out for these kids. Like, these white parents going to talk about you. These black folks going to talk about you. Like, look at that fast-ass girl over there with them motherfucking booty shorts on hanging out. But, you know, it is what it is. It's not my life. So, I got nothing to say. But, yeah, it's funny because you will see people there. And you're like, yeah, you're doing this only for Instagram. But it's fine. I'm okay with that. You know why? Because even though people do shit for the likes, if it gets them to do shit in general, then so be it. You're being active. So be it. I'm not tripping. You know, that's not me. I don't pass judgment, but I judge the shit out of people sometimes. but I have no right to judge. Because whenever I go somewhere to eat, I'm taking a motherfucking picture of my food if it looks good. And I'm posting on Instagram to let these motherfuckers know I be eating. And, you know, I try to just let them know where the good spots are, too. Like Fond du Lac Katrina or whatever, Katrina, whatever. It's in the Seattle on the south side. And they got good Mexican food, good Spanish food. I had a torta the other day. It was a fried flank steak. Now, it was good, man. They had the avocado in that joint. They had, like, some sort of weird mayo in there. They had the torta bread. That bread, man, I don't know what they put. I don't know how they bake it, but they bake the hell out of it, throw some butter on it, and it's just like, man, I wish I was Spanish. My mom's calling me. I'm sorry. I got to decline it. So, yeah, so we did Rattlesnake Ledge. I bet you my mom's going to call me back. I bet you. So, anyways, we did Rattlesnake, and it was a good time. Ended the hike, came back down, went to the Ram, got some food and some beer, and went about our days. That's what you always got to do when you hike. You got to end the hike, and then you got to get a beer with your pals that you went hiking with. Just as a celebration, because beer is good for you. It has all the minerals you need to survive, and that's it. But if you have too much beer and you don't work out or something, you don't get bloated. You have a beer belly, and those aren't fun to have. I'm just not with it. I used to have one in college because I was drinking Miller High Lifes like a motherfucker back then. Just because, you know, you're a poor college kid. $4 for a 6-pack can go a long way. That's a good time. That's a party. So, can't complain. I was drinking that. I was drinking MGDs, which is Miller Genuine Draft. That was my MO back then. And anyways, so yeah, man, we've been dealing with a heat wave up here. It's been like in the 90s, sometimes close to 100, or it's supposed to be close to 100 a few days, and it's been hot as hell. Like today was the first day I didn't have to go poop in the dark in my house. So I'm thankful. I'm grateful for it rained yesterday. It cooled down a little bit. So I was like, yep, I'm going to go poop with the lights on today. I'm not going to sweat. Because that's the worst thing is when you're in a hot bathroom, it's not comfortable. It's going number two in a hot bathroom is just as bad as trying to poop with a heavy jacket on. It just doesn't work. But you make it work, but it's not a good time. You know, so we've been dealing with that for like shit. It hasn't rained here in like 3 weeks, I feel like. And I'm cool with it, though. You know, I liked it. And plus, there's been Canadian wildfires up north. And so all their smoke had came over here. So it's been really hazy for literally like 2 weeks. Makes good photos, though. The sun was looking spectacular. It would it'd be like pink, you know. Wake up, driving to work, joint be big and pink. And I'm like, damn, that's a nice photo op, you know. And but I guess the air was just bad, but whatever. Like, if you go to the south, the sun comes up the same way, all hazy and shit. It's because they're burning garbage and wood and shit all fucking day during the summertime. So it always has that weird burning smell when you ever go out to like the country in these spots. And so it's not as bad of haze like a forest fire, but still it gets pretty hazy down there at times. So, I mean, I'm not tripping. I was running outside too. I didn't give a fuck. I don't care. I just hope that when we're in our 40s, 50s, as Washingtonians, they don't find like some crazy ass lung cancerous disease because of this shit. Like, oh, man, people between the ages of 50 and 60 that were around during the Canadian forest fires, they risk a chance of lung cancer or this new disease called fucking chalky lung. And then you'd be like, damn, son, I got, you know. But that's living life. There's side effects of weird things over time. But I don't think it's the case because it's just wood that's burning. Not like it's heavy smoke either. It's just a little light haze. I started Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. I told y'all that. I've been going for like a month now. Fucked my knee up. But like, it wasn't for Jiu-Jitsu. It was because of some stupid-ass warm-up we were doing. And I don't have hip flexibility. So if I put too much weight on my knee, if I'm literally on my knee, my right knee, and I put a lot of pressure on it, it just pops out of place. And then it pops back in. And that shit feels horrible. I feel like my leg's broken. Nah, I don't. I probably don't feel like that. But doesn't feel good. So it happened to me in boxing class one time because I got up on my knee and it just slid out, slid back in. And I was like, okay. But my knee was fine after that. And then I did this warm-up in class the other day. And it happened again, but it locked up this time. So I'm like, okay, I really hope I didn't tear anything, like my meniscus or MCL, ACL. So I just got to work on, I got to just keep strengthening my leg, man. I'm doing more squats, more repetition versus more weight. So I could build more strength in my legs. So I haven't done leg day. I haven't done leg day in a minute. And I treat muscles like if you don't use it, you lose it. So I got to get back into doing leg day and shit. I don't like it, but I might as well. I just feel like my legs are just too big already. So, but I mean, whatever. It is what it is. I got to keep strengthening my knee because if I lose strength in my knee, dog, and I got to get surgery, I'm going to be mad as hell because nobody wants to have surgery. There's so many old people that be talking about, yeah, man, I had three knee surgeries. And I'm like, you had what? For what? So I just want to keep myself healthy, keep my ligaments healthy. I don't want to do dumb shit, have my kneecaps replaced when I'm 45. I'm not really with that. So anyways, I've been doing jiu-jitsu for a month now. Month and some change. I haven't been getting murked anymore by white belts because obviously when you first start, you're going to get murked. So I was getting choked out, armbarred like a motherfucker all the time. But I'm going to start, I got to start rolling with higher ranks just so I can just be more efficient and just, you know, be on my P's and Q's better in regards to my defense. Excuse me. Because with white belts, nothing against white belts, nothing against myself. Not saying like, oh, when you're a white belt, don't practice with white belts. But when you're both white belts, both of y'all don't know what the fuck y'all are doing. So, honestly, you're just trying shit that you learned in class on each other. Whereas if you roll with a higher rank, like they're going to do some shit that you ain't never even think of. You know, so it's I think it's a better way to learn, obviously, you know. And then, you know, higher ranks, they know how to not fuck you up either. Whereas with a white belt, you know, you might fuck each other up because you don't know. You know what you're doing, but you don't really know what you're doing. So, but I like it. It's exciting. I told myself in 6 months, if I keep getting better and work on my cardio, I want to compete in this. So that's the plan. I just bought another gi. If you don't know what a gi is, because whenever I tell people, oh, yeah, I got my gi, they're like, what's a gi? A gi is your uniform, basically, for jiu-jitsu class. It comes with the jacket, you got the belt, and then you have your pants. So I got another gi because I don't feel like wearing the same gi all the time for class. And, you know, you got to mix it up. It's like an outfit, you know. I gotta get another one eventually. I want to have three in rotation. But it's fun, man. I just hate when I come into fundamentals class and, cause I did fundamentals class on Tuesday, but I never did a Tuesday class, and it's a professor teaching a whole different, thing. So he's like right in the middle of what he's teaching. And so I'm coming in, never even did the shit. I got people in there that's been doing it for like maybe a few weeks now. So I'm like, damn, I don't know what the hell I'm doing. So he worked with me, though. That's what I like about it, is that he worked with me, and I figured it out. And then after that, it got smooth like butter. So, I don't know. Helps me get in shape. I think the lightest I was last week was like 202, and then I had a cheat day, obviously. And so I got to get back. Got to get back to it. I'm going to see if I can hit 199 by next Friday. If I could do that, then, you know, I'll feel all right. I went to Seafair I took my mom and her man friend to Seafair. Seafair is a big festival sort of thing that lasts a weekend. I mean, it lasts basically almost all summer. They have different events and stuff, but the main event is with the hydroplane races and the plane show and or the air show and all that stuff. And it's cool. Like, it was fun. But what I do know is that being on a boat at Seafair is way better. So it was cool, though. I liked it. I had a good time. We had our little lawn chairs out, you know, kicking it. And I do know that one day eventually I'm going to get a boat and go to Seafair instead. So just because it's a fun time. Like, cause I was looking at my friend's Instagram stories and shit, people are, you know, and it's like, damn, you're having a good ass time blacking out on a boat. It sounds better, you know. But you know, you with your parents, you can't be rowdy. It's not fun. But yeah, if you ever go to Seafair or ever think about going to Seafair, be on a boat. You're gonna have a crazier time on that. Better experience. Where we at? 30 minutes? I'm gonna put this on pause so I can call my mom back, because she's gonna keep calling me. Okay. I'm back, I think. I hope I don't lose this audio. If I lose this podcast, because I don't know what the fuck I'm doing, I'm going to be really upset with myself. So I had to call my mom. You always got to call your mom. All right? Anyways. Yeah, so one thing I do know is that if you're an only nephew, right, and they know you lift weights and shit, you will get volunteered to help people in your family move. Now, I love my uncle, you know, and this man had me help him move for like 9 hours last Sunday. It was good, though. It was all right, because it wasn't a bad move. So, because, like, there's good moves and there's bad moves. When I moved my mom lived in a fucking 3-story apartment, right, living on the top floor, and then she wanted me and my roommate to help her. And I was like, I'm not helping you no more, mom. I'll hire movers with you, and we can just do it that way, because I'm not doing this. Because my mom has so much stuff, and like, it's just rough. And then what else was crazy was that the weekend before that, I helped my best friend's mom move. And I was like, damn, son, I've been moving all summer. I ain't even moved nothing from my house. So like, me helping everybody move last couple of weeks, it made me want to be like, damn, I don't think I want to move anymore. But then I was like, nah, I'm going to still move. One thing I do know about myself, I can't stay in one spot forever. Originally, I was like, yeah, I'm going to stay in Tacoma forever. Then I was like, no, I'm not. I'm going to get the fuck out of here. I love Tacoma. I love Lakewood, especially Lakewood. But there's some other things I want to take care of, and I got to move up to the city, man. So I think, well, I got like 7 months, 6 months until then. I'm going to move up to Seattle and just get it popping, man. I want to work on my writing. I want to do some more open mics. And I'm just going to make it happen, man, and just see what happens. I'm 27. You know, you're only young once. I ain't got no kids to worry about. All I got is my bills and my car. And so, you know, I'm going to move up there and just get it cracking, see what I can do with it. Because I like my writing. I like writing more than any other hobby or side things that I do, right? I did a few poetry open mics. And the feedback I get from my poems is like, dang, I like this. It feels good in my heart. I like when people clap for some shit that I wrote, you know? So I'm just going to pursue that amongst some other things too. Like, I want to see if I can get into some freelance writing, maybe some articles and shit. I went to school for that, and like, I'm actually a decent writer, but I just never pursued it because it's like, I like doing things, but sitting and writing is hard for me to do, yet I can do it. I just have to be able to focus that energy, learn how to focus my energy better into writing versus getting caught off guard. But I think whenever I get caught off guard and my ADHD kicks in, I think it helps me write better. It's just a longer process. So like, I think I don't know. I like it though. It's a longer process because it forces me to think and regain my focus. But then whatever caught my attention, I could actually put that towards what I'm writing, you know? So I don't know. It's just my thoughts. Me with my thoughts and my other thoughts. And I don't have no thoughts, if you know what I'm saying. Anyways, so helped my uncle move for 9 hours. It was like a work. It was like a shift, but it was a good time. Got to hang out with my uncle and my aunt. I always appreciate their company. So, you know. And so what else happened, man? I went to the gay club the other day. Not the other day, but like a few weeks ago. First we went out. We met up downtown Tacoma, me and one of my buddies. And we met up with some friends out in the spot, the Forum and the Office. Some of y'all know where that's at. We were out there, you know, drinking, chilling. And then one of my good friends, recurring guest on my podcast, Tadarwin, he was out and about acting bougie. So we went ahead and just followed that fool because he was like, oh, I'm going to the Silverstone. And for people who don't know, Silverstone is Tacoma's number one gay club. It's downtown. It's a fun time. And so we knew he was going there, but we didn't tell him we were going to go. So Mary was with me too, Mary and her boyfriend. So I was just like, yo, let's meet up with Tadarwin, blah, blah, blah. And she was like, well, he didn't invite us, blah, blah, blah. And I was just like, fuck it, let's just go. And so we went to the Stone, right? And I had my friend with me. Now my friend, he's like, you know, I don't want to say he's homophobic, but in certain settings, he will get rattled. And so me, I'm a type of individual where I don't give a fuck where I'm at. I'm comfortable in my own skin. I'm comfortable around whoever. And I don't feel no type of way. I don't feel no type of way no matter where I am. You could put me in the middle of Pride, maybe. I don't know. It's aggressive in there. You could put me in, I can go to Pride festivals. I can go to a motherfucking redneck country show. And I'm going to still manage to have a good time because it's like, I don't give a fuck about my surroundings. Like, I'm not going to let that dictate my fun, you know, just because I'm around people that I'm normally not around often. Because it's like, you know, life's too short for that shit anyway. So anyways, we go to the gay club. I took my friend with me. I was in there dancing, you know, not dancing on dudes or anything. No, I don't do all that. But I was dancing by myself, hanging out, having a good time because the DJ was playing some good shit. You know, so anyways, so we're in there. This motherfucker is shook the entire time. Like, it was like trying to get a kid to swim that's scared of water. So he was in that motherfucker. We was in there not 5 minutes talking about, man, can we leave? Can we leave, dude? I don't like it in here. Blah, blah, blah. And I'm just like, man, what do you mean? Like, because I think I've said this before on a previous podcast, but what I find so fucking hilarious is that straight guys that never really been around, you know, the gay community, gay people, whatever, they just assume that gay men, all because they're gay, that they want them, right? Like, gay dudes don't got standards, you know what I mean? So, like, he's in there thinking, like, oh, like, someone's going to drug his drink, or he's going to get hit on by a bunch of dudes, someone's going to try and take him home, all this shit, you know, get pressed. Get the fuck out of here, right? Because I feel like gay men are the first motherfuckers to call your ass ugly if you're ugly. So I'm not even, so it's like that, I found that shit hilarious because I've been around people that are homophobic and like their justification on like why they want to be around certain people, you know, gay men or whatever, it's so fucking silly to me because it's like, all because that man is gay over there, that doesn't mean he likes you, doesn't mean he wants you, doesn't mean he wants anything to do with you. He could think you're a fuckboy and not want to say anything to you because he thinks you're a square ass motherfucker, and he's like, ugh, get that motherfucker out of my face, right? Or, you know, anal, you could get hit on by somebody that thinks you're cute. But the thing about it is that I know gay men, they know if you're straight, right? I'm in the club. I'm in that place. I've been to a couple of gay bars in my life. They know I'm straight, so they don't approach me. They don't approach you if they know you're straight. They're just going to go about your business because they don't want no bullshit. They don't want to deal with no bullshit. Now, every now and then, you may come across someone that, you know, is out of pocket, and they will say some shit to you. But you just got to laugh about it. I laugh about it. Be like, ha, 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 ha. Thank you. And then they'll be like, can I buy you a drink or something? I'll be like, nah, you're going to put some motherfucking shit in my shit. Next thing you know, I'm going to be out this bitch looking crazy. I ain't, you know, I don't got time to be dealing with that. But thank you for your compliments, sir. And I go about my way, you know. But that's in general. Same thing about a chick. Some chick act, you know, some chicks might act crazy. Be like, can I get you a drink? You never know. A straight chick could put some shit in your shit, take you home. Next thing you know, you got a fucking video on Pornhub you didn't know about, you know. I don't know. I'm just saying. You never know. So I don't get drinks from nobody unless, like, I can read them and I'm like, okay, you're cool, whatever. But all I'm saying is, all in all, if you're homophobic, don't be homophobic. It's not worth being homophobic because most chances are these gay people don't give a fuck about you. If you're cute and they say you're cute, go about your day. Like, I don't understand why people get so rattled about that shit. Like, oh, I don't want people to think I'm gay. Okay. Like, I'm into art. I like writing poems. I like writing. I like art, you know. And you got, you know, your friends are always gonna test you, press you, whatever, say some dumb shit. That's what guys do. That's what men do. You know, we make fun of motherfuckers for doing shit like that, you know. And it's a part of life. But if, like, if you're really that rattled because you think someone may think you're gay or something, and it's like, no, I'm not. Like, get the fuck out of here. Like, I always feel like people like that, they got some weird in the closet shit. They're still wrestling around with their sexuality, and they're not comfortable to be around other people because they're not comfortable with themselves yet. You know what I mean? Like, me personally, I'm comfortable with myself. I like women. I like big women. I like skinny women. I don't really like skinny girls. No offense to skinny women. You're still beautiful. But I'm saying, I like a thick thang with some hips, with some curvations, you know. And, you know, you got your types. And I know what I like. And I know what other things I like. And a man, I don't like men. I know that. And I know it. So it's like, I can go to a gay club and I'm fine because I'm like, I don't like you. And I know I don't like you. But I'm okay with being here because I know I like myself and I know the things that I like. And I'm comfortable enough with myself that I'm comfortable to be around you. You know? That's how it is. I don't know. I don't even know how the fuck I ended up trying to sell myself to thick girls. I don't know why I did that. I was just like, yeah, I like thick girls. Like, motherfuckers is going to email me like, hey, I heard you like thick women. Let's go on a date sometime. It don't work like that. I'm about to get a fucking eHarmony account when I'm like 35. Just because that's the time and age. That's the age that we live in now. I don't know. There's some girl. This is just me. This is Jovan talking about his personal life. There's some girl that hit me up. Like, she was talking like she wanted to, like, have something, right? And it's like, I was getting pressed. She was pressing me. You know, like, because I wasn't being aggressive in, like, making moves. Like, oh, we should hang out and get dinner sometime. Blah, blah, blah. Like, but the motherfucker was moving away. And I'm like, I don't know why I'm getting all this flack. Like you really want to pursue something out of this. And your ass is fucking moving. Like, why are you doing this? So, I don't know. Me, personally, I just look like a cool guy. I'm a nice person. But I know when my time's going to get wasted. And I'll waste my time with you. And I'll do some dumb shit with you. But if you don't hear from me in 6 days, 4 days, obviously, I already caught on to the trick. So that's how I get down. Like, I know when my time's about to be wasted, right? So you just gotta play along, right? You hang out. And then you just got to go. They think y'all got something going on, right? You just don't talk to them for a week. You go about your day. They're going to be mad as fuck at you. Like, oh, you can't talk to me blah, 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 for fucking 4 days, blah, blah, blah. Yeah, motherfucker, I ain't going to talk. For what? For what? You came out of here. You knew you were going to waste my time. You're going to waste this whole situation because of some shit, right? Just because I'm okay looking, right? And just because I already caught on, now you mad. Like, no. Get the fuck out of here. You can't, no. If you don't waste somebody's time and then they know you're going to waste their time, and then next thing you know, they just stop fucking with you because they're like, you're going to just waste my time. And you get mad at that. Dog, you silly as fuck. Anyways, I was selling shirts yesterday at one of my festivals. I did music and arts at Wright Park in Tacoma. And while I was there, you know, it gets a little slow sometimes. And I was writing and stuff. And then this girl and her mom came to my booth talking about, hey, you know, my daughter, she's interested in buying a t-shirt, blah, blah, blah. And I was like, yeah, it's cool. You know, only, you know, 10 bucks. And she was like, okay, blah, blah, blah. And then, like, the girl, she ain't say like one word. She was super shy, right? She was rattled. And it dawned on me, man. It dawned on me because I was that same person at one time. I can be shy, but ever since I got a decent job and I've been smoking CBD oils, my anxiety levels go further down every day. Because I used to have crazy anxiety about talking to people and stuff like that. But then after a while, you just gotta be like, man, fuck that. I'm comfortable with myself. I'm confident in myself. I'm doing things that I say I'm going to do when I do it. And you can't let your little anxieties on how people may feel about you or whatever, or yourself or whatever, get the best of you. Because the world is a crazy place, man. So anyways, dawn on me, man. I just want to be the voice for these shy individuals, you know. Like, I like coming across people that are shy because I'm still shy. But it's just because, you know. It's you gotta get comfortable with yourself, and eventually I want these people to be comfortable with themselves as well, and to be able to go out and do what they want, and to build on their confidence, and to get out that bubble that they set for themselves, because you know they had maybe one bad interaction being a kid, and it kind of just put them in this hole. Like my thing was, I was a fat ass boy, all throughout elementary school, and you know. I never got too much love from the opposite sex, you know, for a while. And so my confidence levels was crazy. You can ask my friends. Like, there's girls that, you know, you have little crushes on and shit in middle school and whatever, some in high school. And I was shy as fuck. And I would say dumb shit because I didn't know what to say and stuff like that. And, yeah, they'll tell you. I was a fucking weird ass kid, and I'm still kind of weird, but I embrace that shit now. You're not gonna beat my ass because I'm weird. So, but yeah, so you just have to get to a point where you get comfortable with yourself, and I think podcasting helped too, because you know, ever since I dropped the first podcast years ago, not even years ago, maybe a year ago, people that I've grown up with, or people that you know I don't really talk to as much anymore, because obviously we're adults now, and you know life moves. And like I'll get a message or someone might approach me and be like, yo, I've listened to your podcast. That shit is good. And I'm like, really? They're like, yeah, man. And I'm like, all right, cool. Thank you. I appreciate the feedback. Because really, I'm just talking in a microphone, talking shit. But, you know, it's just me expressing my thoughts and my mind. Because when you grow up as a shy child for so long, it's just really hard to express yourself. So once you figure out your outlet, the rest is yours, man. Then you ain't really that shy no more. And then you're looking at motherfuckers that want all the attention, and you're looking at that motherfucker like, you ain't, fuck you. No, you don't look at them like that. But you know what I mean? They don't really have too much going for themselves because they're too worried about people liking them or whatever. And they kind of get shit misconstrued. And next thing you know, they're almost 30 years old living at the grandma's house. You know what I'm saying? You know what the fuck I'm talking about? So anyways, Yeah, man. My last festival is coming up. ArcheeBlanco is the brand. We'll be at the Seattle Tattoo Expo. I got to figure out where my business license number is or I ain't going to be able to do it. But it's 3 days long. I'll be in the Fish Pavilion at the Seattle Center near the Space Needle for 3 fucking days. I should just get a hotel, but I'm just going to go back to Tacoma every day. Excuse me, because it's only 40-minute drive. No big deal. So, yeah, it's going to be a good time, though. I'm excited. So I might be working that joint by myself, but, I mean, it's not a big deal. You could do anything by yourself except lift heavy shit. After this expo, I finally get a break, and I'm just going to, like I said, I'm going to focus on this writing. I'm going to see about these poetry open mics, and I'm going to get it popping, man. Yeah, just trying, you know, see what I can do with it. Because I like writing. I got a lot of shit on my mind. Yeah, man. Yeah. Yeah. Anyways, CBD oils and cigarettes. For those of you who smoke cigarettes, I'm not like a smoker. I'm a social smoker. So when I drink, I'm going to smoke a cig. But if you're smoking CBD oils and you hit a cigarette, prepare to get fucked up. It gives you a weird head rush, because what I did, I always forget about CBDs, is that CBDs is not going to give you the psychoactives of weed. So you're not going to feel high, but you still feel the weed, and it's just a weird feeling. So you get a head rush. I don't know why I told you, but I just had an experience the other day of doing both of those things, and it did not feel good at all. And I'm never going to do it again. So I'm just giving you guys forewarning. For those of you that smoke cigarettes and weed, CBDs, I don't know, just don't mix them. It's not a good time. What else I got for you? Not falling in love. Not into falling in love. I don't know why I wrote that. I know why I wrote that. Too busy. At least once a month, I have a conversation with either my mom or my dad or my stepmom, talking about why don't you settle down and find someone nice and, you know, maybe start a family. And I'm like, this is hard. It's hard to do because I'm always moving, man. I'm always doing shit, right? And so I can't see myself falling into love with someone unless we're part of the same, we got the same path going, same lifestyles going, right? Like, I was dating a girl recently, actually. Not recently, maybe like a couple of months ago. She's really cool, into art. She appreciates the art. We went to a few art galleries together. She does crafts herself. She's really good at crafting and planning things. But like, we just had different kinds of lifestyles. Like, my lifestyle is I like to be active. I like doing things. Like, and she's active. You know, she's in the outdoor stuff, doing things outdoors. But me, I did my yoga. I go to the gym. I like running stairs. Like, I like athletic, active stuff. Even though I'm still fat as hell, I still like to do those things. Jiu-jitsu was the main thing that I was so focused on signing up for. And when I signed up for it, I was fucking hyped, right? So, we like being active, but we just like the different activities. And, yeah. So, we just had different lifestyles. We dealt with things differently. Like, me personally, if we have a disagreement, I say, fuck it. I'm not worried about it. I know you. You know me. Leave it at that. But then, like, when we had a disagreement, she'll, like, keep wanting to, like, go back to it and keep coming back to it. And I'm like, we can't deal with these stresses. So, overall, man, I just think relationships are hard. But I think in this generation, there's half of us that can do them at this age, and the other half just can't, because it's really hard to do. Unless you find that person that you're willing to build with, then it's easy, right? You understand what's going down. You understand what you're building on. But if you're like me, you lack patience. I can't do it right now, man. So, I don't know, man. So I feel like for those of you out there, you know, you don't be hard pressed because you're not married and the rest of your friends are. I say this every time. Just life is life. Your time, it's not your time right now. So, I mean, all because you're not about to have kids or anything doesn't mean you're never going to have kids. All because, you know, everyone thinks you should get married, it doesn't mean you have to force yourself into a relationship and force someone to love you and marry you and shit like that. Because I almost fucked around one time and got married. Well, I didn't almost get married. Like, we were just, it was always a part of the conversation. And, you know, I was like fucking, I was like 20, right? Obviously, when you're 20, your brain ain't fully developed, right? So, luckily, I didn't do that. I would have definitely been divorced by now. But, yeah, it was always like a conversation. And, but the fights were too crazy and they kept getting crazier. So, I realized, like, man, this ain't for me. So, like, and then after a while, you know, you soul search a bit, you figure your shit out, you hit your low points, you come back out of that low point, and then that's when you start really appreciating yourself and your time, and just yourself overall. And, like, so technically, you can tell, I haven't had a serious girlfriend in, like, 5 years, just because, like, I just don't have the time or the patience to fuck around. And, like, I remember I dated one chick for like a year off and on, and just because she had a big butt, and that's what just kept me coming back. And, you know, you do stuff like that, and, you know, you shoot yourself in the foot. I shot myself in the foot, and I realized it. Do I regret it? No, she had a nice butt. Whatever. You live your life, you're a man. You put your pants back on, you get back to business, you know? So there was that, and then, you know, you have to date event. You have to date occasionally, though, just because you just don't want to be that hermit crab, just focused on yourself, because, you know, everybody needs love. So, yeah, so, I mean, I still date every now and then, hang out, get to know people, whatever. But serious relationships, I haven't had one of those in a minute, and it's just because it's so, it's just, I don't know. You haven't, you know, obviously you don't find that person to get serious with. Because now it's like everything's transitioned in life, kind of moved over a shade. Like, you know, back in the day, you date a little bit and then you find your wife. Literally, that's how it goes down. Whereas this day and age, you know, you date a little bit, you get to know someone, then you guys get kind of serious, and then you get really serious, and then you might marry, you know, which I like that idea better. Because there's way more steps involved. My parents got divorced when I was 4. And so my dad figured it out real quick. And so he's been with my stepmom since like the last 23 years now. So shout out to them. The anniversary was actually the other day. So, I mean, it's like that, man. I just don't want to get stuck in some shit. Because I'm over here not thinking. You know, not thinking like, am I really compatible with this person? Nah. You just gotta let it go. But it gets difficult though. Because you deal with people like, you know, you deal with a person that's almost like you, like y'all are both hard headed as fuck, right? Or like they have different intentions than you do, but you know, you guys keep coming back to each other, but you know damn well it's not gonna last. You get into that rut is fucking horrendous. It takes so much energy out of you. I was doing dumb shit. So you gotta just chill. But yeah, you know, you figure it out, you grow up, you mature, you learn, you live. Then you can be friends with some of these people, you know. I saw like there's, you know, I dated a couple girls, women. And then, like, it didn't work, but, like, we're still cordial. I can see them in public and say, hey, how are you? Not a big deal. So, for those of you people that say you can't be friends with people, like, get the fuck out of here. You can still be friends and just know that, hey, it just didn't work. And just go about your business. So, I don't know. That's what I got going on for the rest of the month. I got the Seattle Tattoo Expo. Week after that, I got McGregor and Mayweather fight. and my fantasy football draft with the squad. I'm going to be the back-to-back fantasy football champion. I'm telling y'all motherfuckers that right now. What else? Oh, one of my good friends is getting married. Labor Day weekend. And then I think that same weekend, me and one of my other guys, we're going to go out to Oregon. They got a golf tournament happening, and we just want to go and watch. So that's the plan. We'll see if it happens, but that's the plan. You know, ride out there on Friday, come back Saturday night, and I got that wedding on Sunday. That should be a really good time, because there's going to be some fuckers I haven't seen in years that are supposed to be at this wedding. So I'm actually really excited for it. I'm looking forward to seeing the faces that are going to be there, man. And I'm just going to dance and have a good time. So I can't wait. What else, man? That's it. That's all I got for y'all, man. Gave y'all 55 minutes. Icing my knee currently. I got to go to the gym. I got a meal prep. Don't forget to meal prep, man. Don't make excuses for yourself. There's no such thing as excuses. If you got time to take a nap in the middle of the day, you got time to focus on your fitness. You know what I'm saying? You got time to fucking watch The Bachelor. You got time to do something else and be physical and work on your grind. You know what I'm saying? So always keep moving, man. Always figure out your shit. Always find your passions. Stay active. Stay after your passions. Everybody that ordered the Lakewood hat, thank you for your support. Everybody that still goes on ArcheeBlanco.com to buy some shit, thank you for your support. Spreading the brand, whatever, you know what I mean. So next, you know, thank you for supporting my other passions, my other hobbies and shit. I like to design stuff every now and then and put it on t-shirts and sell it to people. I don't really make too much money off of it because, you know, people think, man, you rich now, huh? Nah, motherfucker. Like, there's people you gotta pay for manufacturing, you gotta pay for the shipping, you gotta pay for marketing. I'm just doing it because I don't want to be one-dimensional my entire life and just go to work and come home. That's not my style. So, anyways, do the best you can in life, man. Also, remember, all Trump supporters aren't racist, but all racists are Trump supporters. I heard that on a podcast. That shit was the craziest shit I've heard in my life. So, all you motherfuckers in Virginia, swinging them torches around like y'all gonna do something, come up to Seattle with that shit. We'll smack the fuck out you. So anyways, y'all have a good night. Stay out of trouble. Don't go to jail over some girl, because that's stupid as fuck. Learn from your losses. Keep getting better. And just keep building on something that you want to build on. Keep learning all that shit. Other than that, man. I'll say it again. Stay out of trouble. Kiss your mother on the forehead for me. Give your dad a handshake. I'll be back next week, motherfuckers.
Your name. might find. You couldn't trade me for another, 'cause I think you're so sexy.